Hello and welcome everyone. I'm your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. This time around, you will learn how to utilize Illustrator's opacity mask and create some great type effects. Up next. All right, so let's go ahead and start this off inside Adobe Illustrator with a new document open. I'll go ahead and grab the type tool and just type onto the canvas. Now, for these text effects and for better results, I would recommend choosing a sans font family and a font weight of bold. So in this case, inside the properties panel, I'll set the character here to Arial. For font style, I'll set this to black. I'll up the font size to 120 points. And I'll do the same for the leading value here. Set this one to 120 points. For tracking, I will up this to 75 to be able to have some space between those letters here. For the paragraph, I use align text center, and I'm also going to center the whole text layer to the artboard horizontally and vertically. Now for this text effect, we're going to use multiple strokes. So inside the layers panel, I'll go ahead and click and drag this text layer right on top of the plus icon to create a duplicate, and then just target this duplicate here. And then I'm going to swap between fill and stroke since we're going to be using multiple strokes. I'll double click to rename this to stroke and then hit enter return. I'm also going to lock this layer temporarily and toggle off its visibility and just work in this masked artwork text layer. So the plan here is to create a bunch of horizontal lines that will go inside this text layer using an opacity mask. An opacity mask provides the shape through which other objects show, and the masked object defines which areas are transparent. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and grab the pen tool. Click once to create the first anchor point. I'm going to go right across here, and I'm pressing the shift key onto the keyboard to create this first segment. And inside the properties panel, I'm just going to make sure that I've set this stroke to 1 point. So I'm just going to bring this down closer to the text layer. And then I'm also going to create a duplicate. So that would be Alt Shift Option Shift. Right there. So in order to create those bunch of horizontal lines, we're going to blend them together. So with the selection tool, mark and select these two horizontal lines, and also double check your work inside the layers panel. Those two are selected, and under the object menu, blend. And before we make the blend, let's go ahead and look inside the blend options. So by default, the spacing is set to smooth color. I'll go ahead and set mine to specify steps. And for that, I'm going to use 80 and then click OK. So back on the object menu, blends, and let's create those blends. Great. All right, I'm also going to just notch this down a bit. This one, I'm using the down arrow key on the keyboard, like so. So with these blend lines, let me rename this to blend lines. I'll target them. And then under the edit menu, I cut the lines. That copies the lines to the clipboards and removes them from the artboards, as you can see here. So next, let's go ahead and target this text layer. And we also need to have the transparency window open. So under the window menu, go ahead and bring up the transparency and just make sure that this is not collapsed. So in this case, click on the panel menu and then show thumbnails. So with the text layer targeted and inside the transparency panel, click on the panel menu and then make opacity mask. As the result, next to the opacity mask thumbnail, which is this one right here, now we have a big black area, this one right there. This is the mask area. So whenever we want to work in the mask, we work inside that. So in this case, let's go ahead and click to target the mask. And looking inside the layers panel, it says opacity mask. This is because we just work in the mask now. So the next step is pasting the horizontal blend lines we cut previously into the mask. So for that, under the edit menu, go ahead and choose paste in front. All right, now we still cannot see the lines, and that's because we pasted black stroke lines inside a mask also filled with black color. So all we have to do is check what it says, invert mask, and now we can see the blend lines are perfectly masked inside the text area. Now, in the event that you want to deactivate the mask, first target the opacity mask and then shift click the object's mask thumbnail inside the transparency panel. To reactivate the mask, repeat the same process by targeting the opacity mask and then shift click the object's mask thumbnail. So we've got the horizontal lines inside the masked area. I'm also going to create another duplicate of the text layer and have a background color assigned to it. So with the stroke layer selected, I'll click and drag this right on top of the plus icon to create a duplicate. I will unlock this, toggle on the visibility, target it, and then swap between stroke and fill. So with this fill color here on top, and inside my libraries, I'm just going to assign a color of my choice. And back on the layers panel, double click and rename this to BG and then lock it so I don't accidentally move it. So let's go back to this text layer, target this, back on the transparency and then click on the mask and then target the blend lines. And I'm doing this because I'm going to add some effects and make things a bit more interesting for these text effects. So under the effect menu, the first effect will be under distort and transform, and that will be the zigzag. All right, so with this example here, I'll set the size to, I'm going to use the up arrow key or the down arrow key to perhaps set the size to 4 or 5. Absolute is fine. The ridges per segment, I'll set to 6 or 7. Again, I'm using the up arrow key or the down arrow key on the keyboard. And the rest, I will leave it as is. All right, that's one thing. For another effect, I'll go back to the effect menu. Under distort and transform, I will use the roughen effect. Okay, with these settings here, this is way too pronounced for my tastes. So I'll bring the size down to 2%. I will leave this to relative. Detail, I'll set this to something quite small. Let's say to 1. I'm also going to, for the points, use smooth points and then click OK. All right, with still the blend line selected, instead of having stroke, I'm going to swap to a fill. You see that? And things have changed dramatically, which means now I need to go back and edit one of the effects. In order to do that, still with the blend line selected, go up to the window menu and then bring up the appearance palette. Here's the zigzag and the roughen effect. So if you want to edit the effect, all we have to do is double click on it. So for the size, I'll set this to 1%, but for the detail, I will up this to 2 or 3. I'll leave mine to 2 and then click OK. All right, so this is one thing that looks good, but how about moving the object's mask inside the opacity mask? If I do that using the selection tool and targeting the opacity mask, everything will move along with it. So I will go ahead and undo that, Control Z or Command Z. And that happens because we have the chain icon indicating the opacity mask is linked to art. I will click to disable the icon and unlink those two, target the mask, and now I can reposition those lines within the opacity mask whatever I wish to. Then I will rotate that a bit, position it. I can actually just stretch this out a bit. After all, these are just horizontal lines. And in addition, another thing I can do is I can go back to the object menu, blend, and I can change the blend options. So for example, instead of say specify steps 80, maybe I can set this to 20. Now things have changed a lot, or I can bring this to 120. You see, it's all about what works on your end. Just going to cancel this out. I just want to show that you can still go back to the blend options. Again, I can reposition this to my liking. I kind of like what I see here and go back to the opacity mask. And now I'm ready to go to the next step and add multiple strokes. All right, on to the last step. Let's go ahead and create multiple strokes for the text layer. So we've got the stroke layer, that's what we created initially. Just going to toggle on its visibility, unlock it, select it, and target it. We're going to add additional strokes. We're going to accomplish this inside the appearance palette. So in this case, I will click on the panel menu to add a new stroke. Click on the panel menu again and add an additional stroke. So I've got two strokes here. So I'll set the first stroke to 5 points, and I'll set the second stroke to, let's say, 10 points. For the first stroke, I set the color to white. And for the second stroke, I set the color to a color of my choice here. This one in this case. I like what I see. Now, what else can we do? Let's go back to the effect menu. In this case, I'll add a drop shadow. Now, the default drop shadow is quite pronounced here. I'm just going to bring down the X offset to perhaps 1 point, the Y offset to 1 point, and the blur value between 2 or 3. Let's try 2 for now. Click OK. That's what we got. That looks good. Just going to lock this stroke layer here and then create a new layer, which I will click and drag and bring this at the bottom of the layer stack. Double click to rename this to gradient. Hit enter return. In this case, I'll grab the rectangle tool and I'm just going to create a rectangle shape all across. All right. So no need to have any stroke here. So I'm going to set this to none. As for the fill, just going to click to apply a gradient color. All right, that looks good, but I need to be able to edit this gradient. So in this case, I will double click to get to the gradient tool. As you can see, we are using a linear gradient here. So I will change the angle to, let's say, 90 degrees. And as you can see here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 color stops. In this case, I'm just going to use 3 color stops. So I will click and drag and remove this one color stop. Click and drag to remove that color stop. I will click to target this color stop. I'll set the location to 50%. Click to target this color stop. Change the color to this. Click to target the second color stop. Apply this color, and for the third, I will apply this color, but for the opacity, I'll bring this down to 30%. All right, so I like what I see. I'm just gonna leave things as is. As you can see, there's so much you can accomplish with opacity masks, transparencies, and effects. This is just an idea to get you started.